Grandview, Beckley, Charleston.
West Virginia, the fourth annual edition of the West Virginia Jazz Festival, featuring this evening the big band Young Thundering Herd of Woody Herman. Now, from the Charleston Cultural Center, your host for this evening's program, Bill Hairston.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good evening and welcome to the West Virginia Jazz Festival in Charleston, West Virginia. We just want to welcome our fans and all our viewers from all over the state of West Virginia on West Virginia Public Television who are joining us here tonight. We've been having a wonderful time, but we're glad you joined us. You know, a few years ago, in the 80s probably, the disco era and so forth brought people out and people started dancing again. And with that new surge of energy and wanting to dance, all of a sudden, big band music really took off. And people started going out, not only listening, but dancing. And we're real fortunate tonight to have with us one of the best of the big band groups. For 50 years, they've been traveling all over the state of West Virginia, Georgia, and everywhere else, all over America. Ladies and gentlemen, the new Thundering Herd.
Good evening, all. Thank you. Good evening. Of course, I'm sure you've all been informed that Woody is in the hospital, and of course, my name is Frank Tiberi, and I've been with the band for 18 years, and we'll have to say that he's recuperating great. We just saw him last week, and he's in real good spirits and just anxious to come on back. And you know we have to continue with this big band music, and as he has always been interested in giving the opportunity for a lot of young musicians to gain their experiences and become very well known. But this is not a hard position to be in, actually, because the talent in the 18 years that I've been here, I've never seen it as much as I. We've been together for 3 years, and we've recorded the 50th anniversary album, and we just recently completed another album in Concord. That's where we do most of our in Concord, California, for Concord Records. And of course, we have another session coming up with a fine clarinetist, one of the world's greatest, Richard Stoltzman. And as I say, this is the easiest part, actually, to display all of the talent in the band. And we're going to start off this evening with the first cut in the new 50th anniversary album. And that is an old Duke Ellington tune. And I think it just says it all. It's called It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing. And you better believe that. Thank you. It's the Woody Herman Band. Thank you. Actually, the hard part of this whole situation being here and is to the span of 50 years, Woody has just upgraded and just about accepted all great things by great arrangers. And we'd like to do one right now. Just a few weeks ago, we had the Academy Awards, and it was one of the films that were up for the awards. And this featured a great tenor saxophone player by the name of Dexter Gordon. And he was supported by some great musicians such as Herbie Hancock and Tony Williams. And of course, I have to mention that Herbie Hancock got the award for the original score for this particular movie of the same title. But I want to mention that this is not a new tune. This has been written by the father of bebop and the late Thelonious Monk years ago. Now they call it Round Midnight. This is John Fedchock, who's been doing most of our arrangements. A beautiful arrangement that he's done on the tune Round Midnight, and he'll be soloing on trombone.
Thank you.
Jim Fetcher, soloing on his arrangement, Round Midnight to the Bowers Animal. I don't know whether I told you, but that is going to be in the new album coming out soon, very shortly. And we'll be previewing a couple of others also as well. We'd like to go back to 1947 for you fans that have been following the band. At this time, we had a great tenor saxophone player by the name of Jimmy Giuffre that came up with the idea of three tenors and one baritone. And of course, I'd like to mention that it was just inducted into the Hall of Fame. And at that time, we had Stan Getz, Zoot Sims, Herb Stewart, and Serge Shaloff. Now this evening, we have Mike Brignolo, we have Jerry Pinter, Dave Rickenberg, and if you've forgotten, I'm Frank Tiberi. Don't know, that was the four brothers, Mike Brignola and Jerry Pinter, Dave Rickenberg. Thank you. We'd like to follow that up with another beautiful ballad written by Ralph Burns. He was a pianist with the band at one time, and he wrote the Summer Sequence, and out of that came and readapted for the orchestra and featured a great 20-year-old tenor player by the name of Stan Getz. And this is my pleasure playing the solo this evening on Early Autumn. out. By Ralph Burns. Thank you. Yes. We'd like to play another preview. And this is one that's a very, very talented, exciting pianist that wrote this in about 10 years ago. We've done a few pieces by this gentleman. We've done La Fiesta. And everything that he does is exciting. It's Chick Corea. And John came up with the idea. This is one of his compositions in John Fedchuk arrangement. It's called The Samba Song. Starts out with Joel at the piano.
Thank you.
Dave Carpenter on the bass, of course, take a bow. We'd like to at this time, we have recorded this in the past, and we're going to do this again with that famous world's clarinetist, the greatest, as Richard Stoltzman, and this is coming up in May and on RCA. And this is one of the tunes which we've been doing, a beautiful melody, and this gives some of the musicians in the band an opportunity to show their versatility. We have Mike Brignola, will be playing bass clarinet, and we have Miss Diane White. She will be playing the piccolo trumpet. Isn't that nice? So you see, you female musicians don't ever give up, because actually Woody was the first that really has hired a trumpeter way back in 19... What was that, Mr. Byrne? 1943, he says, Mr. Byrne. Our manager, nice round of applause for Mr. Byrne. Without him, we could not exist. He plans all of our bus tours each day, you know, 400, 375. Anyway, this is a beautiful melody written by Fauré, and it's called Pavane. Hope you like it. Mike Pignola, bass clarinet. Diane White, piccolo, trumpet. And of course, me with the original coat hanger here, the bassoon. Thank you. I think it's about time to play the oldest tune we know, and that's the Woodchopper's Ball. Yeah. Got it. Gisbert. We'll be right back. Peter Ingram, our lead trumpeter. And all the boys take a bow. And thank you. We'd like to preview the title tune of the new album to come. And that is going to be called Woody's Gold Star. And how he came about just titling that was the, in Hollywood, of course, if you're ever around the Highland Avenue in the southwest corner of Hollywood Boulevard, you'll see his gold star over there. And I think he'd appreciate it if you just kick some of the cigarette butts away or maybe give it a small shine. This is called Woody's Gold Star, an original by John Fetchock, and title tune of the new album coming out.
Thank you.
Woody's Gold Star. John Fetchock's original and arrangement, original tune, and take a bow, Mike Brignoli, you heard on baritone sax. Now, this coming album that I spoke about that we'll be doing with the famous clarinetist Richard Stoltzman, we're going to be doing also the Ebony Concerto written by Igor Stravinsky years ago. And I think the tune at that time, such as Goosey Gander and many others, and I think the tune that inspired him, well, many of them did, to write this selection for Woody as a gift, was one of the tunes we're going to do right now. And this is called Apple Honey.
Thank you.
Actually, we haven't played that for a while. We're just bringing that out of the books now. But at this time, ladies and gentlemen, I would like personally, and I'm sure all of the other musicians, jazz fans that have known one that has just passed away just recently, I'd like to pay tribute. And he was the most fascinating and impeccable drummer, soloist of all times. Of course, I'm speaking none other than Buddy Rich. And I feel it appropriate to play this tune, which is quite dear to my heart. It's a beautiful arrangement done by John Fedchak, and it's a composition written by John Coltrane, the late John Coltrane. And I think that maybe perhaps, Doran, you might, from your hearts, just give a little thought about such a great musician and what he has contributed. I'd like to play Central Park West. Thank you. so beautifully done. Give credit to Mr. John Fetchoff. He did the arrangement. Along with the other things that we're going to be doing with Richard this coming May, we're going to do something which we have recorded once in the past, and we do it every evening. And this is a bit of Americana. And of course, we all know Aaron Copland. He's done some great compositions. Proclamation, Appalachian Spring, of course, right? One of his most famous is Fanfare for the Common Man. We'll be doing that. But I warn you, we do it the Woody Herman fashion. So if you see Aaron, keep it to yourselves. John, Fanfare for the Common Man.
Thank you.
colleague. Ladies and gentlemen, you've made me very happy. You've made it very relaxed for me. I want to thank you for that, and thank all my colleagues for the support and the talent. As I say, can't go wrong up here. Woody has presented this for years, and I hope it continues and goes forever. And let's hope that he just gets together again and gets back on the stage and cracks the whip as he usually does. And hope to see you again with him up here. Have us back. Thank you. Thank you.
The new Thundering Herd.
Thank you all.
The garden, a beautiful battleground where humans fight invasion by bug and weed. But when gardeners move away, wild plants and animals move in. And in the abandoned garden, the rhythms of a wilder place impose a different order. Natural law replaces human rule, and a pitiless balance is established. Caterpillars strip the rose bushes unchecked, but they also nourish the young robins in the early days of spring. Field mice nest in the garden wall. In a single summer, a single pair can give rise to generations, totaling in the hundreds. But the watchful owl and weasel keep their numbers under control. Throughout the garden, hunters and hunted carry on in their appointed roles, which can change in the blink of an eye. Join us and explore the hidden life and intimate secrets of the forgotten garden. Next time on Nature.
See Nature Sunday at 8.
The garden, a beautiful battleground where humans fight invasion by bug and weed. But when gardeners move away, wild plants and animals move in. And in the abandoned garden, the rhythms of a wilder world impose a different order. Now natural law replaces human rule, and a pitiless balance is maintained. Join us and explore the secrets of the forgotten garden next time on Nature.
See Nature Sunday at 8.
Well, the past depresses me, the present bores me, and the future scares me to death.
This week on Masterpiece Theater, a slightly unorthodox shipboard romance.
I almost forgot. Would you do me the honor of becoming my wife in Fiji on the 5th of July?
Certainly not.
Noel Coward's Bon Voyage on Masterpiece Theater.
See Masterpiece Theater Sunday at 9.
What a powerful band. Woody Herman, the Young Thundering Herd, appeared for the concert at the West Virginia Cultural Center tonight for an outstanding crowd, a very appreciative crowd. And the director of the band tonight, Frank Tiberi. As many know, Woody Herman has been sick for about 3 weeks, hasn't he, Frank?
Yes, just about 3 weeks.
Uh-huh. And I was listening into radio in Chicago, WGN, 3 weeks ago on Mike Rapchak's program, and he said that he had suffered some type of altitude sickness and was transferred to a Detroit hospital?
Yeah, it was suggested by his personal doctor and friend, Stan Levy, to get on in and have a change of medication. Of course, he'd had a little problem with just some fluid in his lungs and everything, just to be general checked right on through, and I think that was a wise thing because, as I say...
What is his condition now, Frank?
The condition now is he's up out of bed, out of intensive care, and he's eating food, whole food, and he's got good spirits. So I think that it should be really coming around a bit.
So the prognosis is that he'll be back on the road and...
Well, he's, I'll tell you, a week ago, he's been pulling out his tubes to come back on the road. Mm-hmm. I mean, he'll be on the road as fast as he can possibly make it.
You know, I'm bringing up what a powerful band appearing before a wonderful crowd here at the Cultural Center. You direct the band. You're a veteran of 18 years with Woody Herman. It's a lot of fun to work with this type of band, isn't it?
Well, I think that just tells it all, right? 18 years. And, of course, I mean, I decided to retire at the age of 40.
Why?
And, well, as I wanted to play music, and Woody was always the type band that could supply music that you can be on a road band and play, you know, as music that you like to play. And of course, I mean, that he likes to play a variety, you know, things that we've done this evening in the past. We've done, you know, things from 1947, and mm-hmm. we have so many new tunes since then, and, mm-hmm. Including the new recording session that we had just completed in Concord. Mm-hmm. For On Concord Records, it'll be called Woody's Gold Star. We've previewed a couple of those tunes this evening.
One recording of the album I had a lot of success with, the 50-year anniversary album.
Excellent.
And you opened up with Don't Mean a Thing, the Ellington number. What a swinger that is.
Certainly is. Woody would only play his music, and he's been a devotee of Ellington for years. I think that's been his... And he'll play any Ellington tune. I don't think he can go wrong with any thing that Ellington has written. Uh-huh. Now also Central Park West is just one of my favorite dear tunes, and of course that's on that album also. I think it's a great album.
And playing with Woody, does he let you have a lot of free expression? And like doing a tune that he says to you, play it the way you want to play it, or do you play the way the arranger put it down?
Well, I think it's been my experience to know that if he likes a certain person, then he would certainly make suggestions on the texture and balance and delivery of a particular tune in its context, and that's what he's been always interested in that. And as I say, I mean, he does make you know, corrections, you know, such as using restraint, and I think that's always been an asset for any musician, and also as me as well.
I mean, I wish I had more time to talk with you, Frank. Continue success, and when you see Woody, give him our best. Will you do
that? Well, I hope so, and I'm sure that we'll be getting along and coming on back.
Thank you for watching, and goodbye.
Thank you now.
Shoulder. 3x3 really adds up on Dan.